Amen. Well, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. This is me, Apostle Esther. I pray that you are already having an amazing day. The Bible says this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I'm finding out that it's a choice to rejoice. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. It is a choice to rejoice. I tell you, God's word will just bring you so much joy, so much peace. We have to make decisions to be happy, to just celebrate the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So just remember that it's a choice to rejoice. It is always a blessing to be with you. I am super excited about the assignment that the Lord has me on. I am simply an ambassador of the Lord Jesus Christ. That means that I am a good news carrier. I'm a message carrier. Just loving the assignment that the Lord has me on. Always excited to share with you what the Lord is sharing with me. I am going to give you a moment to get your Bibles, to get your notepads, to get your iPads. And we're going to get ready to go right into the Word of the Lord. As always, I'm going to hang out right here. I'm going to review my notes, and we're coming right back with the word of the Lord. God bless you. Amen. So we are right back. We're going to go ahead and get the word of the Lord. Today we're going to read from Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. And we're going to go back as well to Ephesians 6 and 10. Yesterday, we were talking on the strength of God over our lives. And so yesterday, I just began to meditate more and more on the word. And I listened to the video over and over again, because a lot of times, as I say, we sometimes hear a word from the Lord and we just let it go over our heads and not get in our heart. And yesterday, I just needed to hear that word, that the Lord is my strength. The song says, what is the song? You're my strength, strength like no other. And I began to sing and meditate on that song, because in this hour, in this time, in this season, we need to understand that we have been mental, we've been yoked up with the strength of God, not our own strength, not our own power. But Paul said, it's by the grace of God that we are who we are. It's by the grace of God that any of us are saved. So we must understand that the strength of God is a grace that God is placing on our lives to be able to get through times, to get through seasons, to get through situations and circumstances that we are dealing with. So let's go ahead and look at Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. And the Bible says, out of the King James translation, it says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with the wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Then one translation says, they that trust in the Lord, or they that gain the strength of the Lord, those that wait on the Lord, the Bible promises that God will renew our strength. And I believe that daily he renews our strength. He takes us, amen, from glory to glory in the strength of him. That's why Ephesians says to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, not in our own power, not in our own will, but in the power of God's might. And in the power of his strength, he gives us this gift of grace to carry us through whatever we're dealing with. And then Isaiah came back and he just so sweetly said, but you gotta wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. And while we're waiting on the Lord, we need to be of good courage, because we know that God is going to carry us through. What is the strength of God? It's the power of God, the vigor of God, the force of God, the will of God that empowers us to get through times and seasons in our lives. And as we wait on God, as we trust God, we have a guarantee on his word that he won't fail us. And if we trust God, guess what? We won't fail him. The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. He gives us the power. He gives us the strength. He gives us the grace to overcome the trickeries and the wiles of the devil. James says that we need to submit to God so that we can withstand the evil one, or we can overcome the wiles of the devil. So we need to understand that this strength is not of our own. That's why he's saying, be strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. We need to begin to understand that we need to rely on the strength of God in every area of our life. When we rely on God's strength, we'll understand that we won't fail in those areas that we consistently fail. And I often think about this, that we go through things, seasons in our lives. And sometimes, and I really believe this, that we have anniversary dates. And when we have those anniversary dates, we have to recognize, identify, and expose. We have to recognize, no, last year I failed at this same time. Last year I failed at this same trial. Last year I failed at this same test. But this year, it is going to be different because I'm going to apply the word of God to every area of my life. The word of God that causes me to overcome. The word of God that causes me to see victory. The word of God that strengthens me. The word of God that gives me wisdom. The word of God that gives me knowledge. The word of God that gives me insight as to who I am, understanding that I am created in his image and in his likeness. And when I'm created in his image and in his likeness, I become God's intended result. So when I become that intended result that God has purposed over my life, I find myself not failing in that same area of my life. I find myself, instead of failing at my anniversary date, I look at that thing and say, "Ooh, I got victory over this." Why? Because I've learned to apply the strength of God in every area of my life. Sometimes we wake up and we just feel the weight of the world, but we have to begin to declare the word of the Lord and say, "God, I'm going to wait on you. I'm going to trust you. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. In thee, O Lord, do I put my confidence that my enemies might not, that my enemies will not triumph over me." Do you understand that the enemy, amen, it is his desire for us to keep failing in areas of our lives. But we have to grow up. We have to wait on the Lord. Paul says that we need to mature in the things of God. He said, in fact, when I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I functioned as a child. But when I became a man, when I came into the maturity of what God was calling and purposing my life to be, I began to act like a mature man or a mature woman of God. Why? Because I don't like failing tests. Amen. I said earlier, I make a choice to rejoice. Why? Because I don't like that repetitive testing. I keep failing the same test because I found out in my life, in my walk with God, that each time I fail a test, it gets harder every time. So when we understand that God has mandated victory concerning our lives, we need to hold on to his word and trust him, wait on him, and understand that the intended result of God concerning our life is to place us in a position of victory and not a position of defeat. So we can depend on God's insuperable strength. That means the supernatural strength of God to get us through the times and the seasons. One Bible says that God will cause times of refreshing to come in our lives. Why? Because we're trusting God. Why? Because we waited on the Lord. Why? Because our hope was in God. Our confidence was in God, that surely God is going to bring me through. So we put our faith in him. We put our trust in him. We put our hope in him, knowing that God is going to see us through and God is going to bring us through. Well, I am Apostle Esther. I am simply an ambassador, a messenger of the Lord Jesus Christ. I love carrying the gospel of the good news. And let me just remind you this, that when we give a word, when we surrender and submit a word, or we release a word from the Lord, the message is always applicable to the messenger. So a lot of times we give the word and God is dealing with us, amen, and testing us and trying us. But he's sitting back saying, but I know they're going to overcome that. I know they're going to come out of that thing with great victory. I want to minister to you today that you are going to come out of this thing. You're going to come through this thing in a greater place of victory, knowing that God cannot and he will not fail me, because there is an intended result concerning my life. I will wait on the Lord. I will trust the Lord, and he shall renew my strength. I want you to have an amazing day, and I ask that you share, like, and if you so desire, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. We'll be back on tomorrow sharing more of the gospel of the good news. Have an amazing day. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining me for my YouTube channel today. God bless you.